Well, if you're looking for a new job, you may find plenty of opportunities down at City Hall. The City of San Diego now has a whopping 2,300 vacant positions. It is a story you will only see here on 10 News. 10 News reporter John Horn uncovered why many San Diegans are having such a hard time, or rather San Diego is finding such a hard time finding new employees and convincing them to stay.
You can step into this office near City Hall and apply for jobs in person. You can even get a list of what they all pay. But when you see it, you may be tempted to look elsewhere.
Accountants in the city of Chula Vista make 22% more, and the list goes on and on and on.
Michael Zuquette keeps copies of job ads from cities across San Diego County. One thing they seem to have in common, their pay and benefits beat the city of San Diego's by far.
You can go to Poway if you're an associate planner in the city of San Diego and make 21% more. Police services officer in the city of San Diego makes 27% less than city of Coronado.
Zuquette heads the Municipal Employees Association, which represents about half of the city's 11,000 workers. He says the booming job market and lagging pay and benefits at the city is leading to more than 2,300 positions going unfilled.
As you hemorrhage employees and have trouble recruiting people to fill their place, operations begin to suffer, and that's what's happening.
The city auditor's office now investigating how San Diego can improve its employee recruitment and retention. City Councilman Scott Sherman weighing in at an audit committee meeting this week.
So we need to do something about that to, I think, change the culture and get it to where employees are really looking forward to going to work and like being where they are.
Rank and file city employees said they couldn't go on camera. But some described low morale, empty desks, and even colleagues quitting without notice. John Horn, 10 News.
Now, we did reach out to the city and mayor's office, but haven't heard back. The city has increased salaries for some jobs, such as 911 dispatchers and police officers, but it stopped offering pensions to most new hires after Measure B passed in 2012.